Hey everyone, yes I do mean you, it's me, Silver Daddy. Are you ready for another exciting adventure, aka trip or trippin, with me? We're about to discover and share some amazing life stories. If I take a few sudden tangent turns along the way, don't worry, because I'll find our way back. Come on, climb aboard and buckle up because we are ready to start another great episode of
Trippin' with Silver Daddy.
Hi everyone, welcome to this week's Trippin' with Silver Daddy. And this week, I'm going to talk a little bit about sports. Yeah, can you imagine me talking about sports? But yes, I love sports. And I'm in my hometown area of Oakland Park, and they just redid all these pickleball courts. Pickleball is a new thing, not really that new, but it's been around for a while, but it's taken off, especially in Southern Florida. You know, sports is really important for adults to do. There's many benefits to being involved in sports, like things that I could use. It can lower your weight. It can lower your body fat. It can also reduce your risk of heart diseases. Let's see, what else can it do? Oh, there's so many things. Also, it's a big benefit in sports just to help with your muscle tone, your bone structure, everything that you can imagine. So active sports is very important to everyone, from when you're a child learning to play sports and being a part of a team, to when you're older and you become more just like wanting to sit around. That's not good for us. Trust me, I know. You need to get out and be active. You know, the other thing that sports can do for you, it can lower your what they call lipid levels. And lipid is that fatty stuff that gets in your bloodstream and then also in your tissues, which you need to have a little, but not too much. We know lipids is probably more like cholesterol. Now, the funny thing is, that's one of the few things my doctor always says. I have good cholesterol. But lipids, you know, if that kind of builds in the arteries, you know, starts clogging the arteries. And when you start having clogs in your drain, you know, it causes problems. So, lipid, high levels of lipid in your thing, it can increase your risk of stroke and heart attack. So there's a lot of reasons we should be involved in sports. But another big one is just a social atmosphere. I mean, look at this. It's actually Sunday morning. There's so many people out here already playing. It's really important to be involved, and it helps you build a social community. You know, they say, if you play a team sport, you are more likely to stick with it than if you do something individually like jogging. You know, it's really easy to quit on yourself. Not as easy to quit on your team. So we're going to talk a lot about sports today. Let's see what my plans are. Well, first of all, in South Florida, it is one of the largest NEGVA softball tournaments going on, the Hurricane Showdown. So we're going to definitely go to the Hurricane Showdown, talk to some people there. That's the big softball. There's teams from all over the United States and internationally even. I heard there's like over 73 teams that are playing, and there's some teams from Canada. So let's go try to find someone from, let's find one of those Canadian guys. Talk to them about softball. We got to get some women on the show. And women love softball. Women kick ass in softball. So we'll find that. We're just going to go around and talk about some sports. I did meet some people the other day that I filmed that I'm going to include that was actually playing football. And I was impressed. So we're definitely going to talk to them. So that's what this week's going to be all about. It's about getting out, having fun, and playing some sports. Hey, everybody, please listen to my sponsor, and I'll be right back. You are listening to Trippin' with Silver Daddy. Be right back.
Do you want to upgrade your home to maybe waterfront property or looking for investment property here in Broward or West Palm Beach counties? And you want it to be hassle-free and stress-free and drama-free? Then you need real estate agent Mark. He has years of customer service and knows this market. Let me tell you, the great thing about real estate agent Mark is he always answers his phone. He's never missing an action.
This is why I recommend real estate agent Mark to my family, friends, and you, my followers.
So it doesn't matter if you live in New York, LA, Dubai, Rome, London, or Rabbit Hash, Kentucky. If you're looking to buy real estate in South Florida, contact real estate agent Mark. You can contact him at PalmBeachRealtor4U.com.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Trippin' with Silver Daddy. You won't believe what just happened. I'm driving freaking Uber out in somewhere. I don't even know where I am in Florida. Remember I was just talking on Thanksgiving show about playing street ball up in Cincinnati on Thanksgiving Day? I'm driving around and all of a sudden, look, there's all these people out there playing football. Where in the hell are they? They're out there somewhere. They're all playing football on Thanksgiving Day. And I have two guys here. Now tell me, Josh, right?
Yes, Josh.
And Nate.
Josh and Nate. I have Josh and Nate here. What I find more interesting, come on up here, guys. They won't hear you. Is how many people down here are homeschooled? You know, I used to be a teacher. That would put us all out of business. But I think it is the best thing ever, especially to homeschool your kids. If you're one of those adults like me that tend to just get up and travel whenever I feel like it, I could have taken my daughter more places. Mm-hmm. You know, we used to could only go scuba diving in the Caribbean during spring break.
Sounds pretty good to me.
So you guys were both homeschooled, right?
Yes, sir.
And you were playing football.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, let's talk about this. There's a lot of guys here playing football.
Mm-hmm.
Is this like a league? Is this a just an annual thing? Or
I mean, it's an annual thing. Every year on Thanksgiving, we come out here with some of our church buddies and some of our other friends. We did play in a league this year. We played like an amateur league with all our friends. That was good. We won every game.
Oh, so now bragging rights. What, your church group or your team?
No, just a friend group.
Okay. So you guys are all a part of a church group. Mm-hmm. What church is that?
It's called The Exchange. And he goes to
I go to Emmanuel Baptist Church.
Okay.
Yeah.
Baptist.
Yes, sir.
So there's no drinking.
Celsius.
Okay, just checking. Because I know the Baptist people. I'm Catholic. Trust me, I know the Baptists. See, at the Catholic festivals, we sell beer. But that's a different thing.
I'll drink some.
He takes communion. Don't worry about that.
The Catholics know how to make money, you know? If we could have had pot, we would have been selling pot at the Catholic church. Trust me, if there's a way to make money, the Catholics know how to get it.
Oh, they do. That's for
sure. Sorry, all the priests at home. But, okay, so back on the homeschool. You both were homeschooled, right? Tell me a little bit about that. Was it hard?
No.
Like, just getting friends and having friends like that?
Well, I don't know. I think for a lot, I'd say like 70-80% of homeschoolers, it is hard. But we played sports a lot through our childhood. I played basketball all my life, so you're around kids all day long, and you make.
Okay, but if you're homeschooled, there's not like a homeschool basketball team you play on.
Yes, there is.
There's
an organization, but also as a homeschooler, you can play on any team's high school team.
Yeah.
You can play on any high school team.
Any school. Yeah.
Oh, so if like this team is really good and they're going to win state, you could say, "Hey, I'm homeschooled and I want to be on your state championship basketball team, so I can get a scholarship to."
That's right.
You got to make tryouts.
I better pick a Florida
that's how Calvary,
right?
That's how Calvary Christian Academy won like 3 championships.
Oh, really?
Yeah. My brother's in that team, Diego Fago, a bunch of now D1 players on that team. I were on that team back in the day.
That's like Cincinnati Moeller back in the 80s. Before you guys were ever even thought about being born.
No, back in Cincinnati, back in the 80s, there was a dominant team nationally called Mahler.
Yeah.
And the guy who coached it became the coach of Notre Dame. And what's so funny about it, his wife was a real estate agent who owned an apartment complex across the street from the school. And all of a sudden, all these kids lived in these apartments right across the street from the school that were from Florida and everywhere. And, you know, they were like national champs, whatever. So, okay, so you can actually play sports in the homeschool.
Yes.
Did you play sports through homeschool?
Yeah. Throughout high school, I played football with a couple of guys that were here.
Okay. So you actually, because I just think of homeschool, it's kind of like, oh, you're just stuck at home the whole time and you're not having all that.
We did like a spinoff where once a week you go to a program, like a church, and they'll have a bunch of kids there, and then you're like in a class once a week. Yeah. They give you the work, and then you go home and do the work, and you come back the next week with the work.
Since there's so many so many of us, it's like there's a bunch of organizations that like do classes, that host classes. So really, like growing up, my schedule is kind of like a college schedule where I have classes a couple days a week, go home, do my homework, come back.
And when you can get it done, you get it done, and then you got free time, and you don't have to.
Or you don't get it done, and nobody cares. That's the problem.
Oh, wait a minute. Josh, are you?
I got it done.
I'm hearing this from Josh. Some people are overachievers with the homework, and some were not, right?
Absolutely not. That's for sure. You can
just got to graduate. That's it.
Right. That's right. My mom signs off. Boom, I'm done.
Bro, I had life on easy mode.
Nah, it wasn't that easy.
Second ago.
No, it was.
Talk to my daughter. She would not have had it that easy. She knows better. So, okay, that is pretty cool, though. Now, what about the other things? Like, did you guys go to college?
Yeah, I'm at FAU right now.
Okay, not homeschooling.
No, I'm actually there.
You're actually there now.
Yeah.
So college, you actually kind of have to show up once in a while.
Yeah, my mom doesn't know what's going on.
It's very similar, right?
Yeah.
Go get your work, go home.
Yeah.
Go on. Yeah, trust me. My daughter teaches some classes up at Purdue.
Yeah.
So I know how that works. This is just really cool. So back to the sports part. This is church groups. You've been doing this for a couple years.
Yep.
Your brother's organizing
this,
right?
Yes. His name's Luch.
Luciano. Luciano. And I'm going to tell you, these guys are damn good. Like, they can actually throw the ball and catch the ball. It wasn't like us back in the 80s. We cheated the whole time. Like, we had all these little runs that was like to cheat and try to get by. These guys are like running plays. Do you guys practice?
No. That's the reason why we're hurt. I'm hurting right now.
I haven't played in years.
They looking good out here.
They're hurting. Oh, my God.
20-year-old back problems.
Oh,
scary.
Well, you know, I have no answers for all that. Wait until you're 60. Well, this was really great. Thank you for spending some time. Hey, everyone, I'll be right back. Please listen to my sponsors. It's Thanksgiving Day. Don't tell anyone.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Bye.
You like premium fetish and leather products? Then you need to go to Leatherworks. That's where I go shopping. They make so many things in-house, and they only use the best quality leather. Leatherworks is inclusive of all sexuality, gender, and body types. So even me, Daddy Bear, can get the perfect fit. You can join the Lifestyle Club program. It offers discounts on in-store products and classes. Yes, they have specialty classes. And they also have community parties. If you need to buy that special gift or want that unique holiday gift, go to leatherworks.com. That's Leatherworks, spelled W-E-R-K-S.com. And you can buy online.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Trippin' with Silver Daddy. As you can see, I'm still at the sports complex. I'm here with Corinne. Corinne is from one of the cities I've never been to, or one of the states I've never been to, but one of my favorite types of food. You're from?
New Orleans.
New Orleans. I love Cajun food.
I mean, it's not horrible. It's true.
It's not. Trust me. Trust me. You guys have good seafood, shrimp. Oh my God. Even alligator.
Alligator is actually quite delicious.
If it's marinated.
If it's done correctly.
Yes. If it's not done correctly, it's chewy as bubblegum.
Agree.
Would you agree with that?
Yes, I do.
If it's done correctly, it melts.
It's delicious. It's like chicken.
Everything's like chicken. That's what we always say.
I know.
Took my daughter to Peru. She had to have guinea pig. She's like, Dad, it's just like chicken. I'm like, I am so sick and tired of everything tasting like chicken.
Did you go to Machu Picchu?
Yes, we did.
Oh my gosh, I'm so jealous.
It was like chicken.
Oh, I bet.
It really was.
Oh, I'm so jealous.
But I've never been to a Mardi Gras.
Whoa.
I've never been, like, I want to go to that Tabasco Island.
I haven't been there, actually.
I hear, like,
I haven't been a good tourist in that way.
I hear if you even get near the island, the pepper smell knocks you out.
I've heard good things like that, yes. I do like spice.
It clears your sinuses, that's for damn sure. I can use that right now.
Oh, my God.
Hey, let's talk a little bit about softball.
Yes.
How long have you been playing?
Since I was 5, so
oh my God.
38 years.
You've been playing a long time.
Yeah.
Played high school then?
Played high school. I'm originally from Massachusetts.
Okay.
So I played up there. I played some in college, but for funsies.
Yeah. Funsies is more fun.
It was more fun at the college level. College,
because there's beer involved.
Exactly. Or if you're in California, another substance.
Yeah.
Or two.
We've already talked about that when I went to the earlier episode. I went to the World Series in Oregon, and the team players bought what are they called, gummies?
The edibles?
Yeah, yes. And I didn't know what it was.
You didn't know?
No, because I work for I work for an airline.
I mean,
so we get drug tested.
Oh.
Well.
Oh, you get drug tested?
Yeah.
Oopsies.
Well, the guy that did it, he's a registered nurse, so I figured he would know better. Greg.
Don't trust them.
Greg.
Don't.
And he gives it to me and he goes, oh, Ritzy, you better have a bigger piece. You're pretty big.
No.
And I'm like, okay. Oh, my God.
Uh-huh.
We went to the opening party and I just stood there and watched everyone. I was like,
why are they so entertaining?
Oh, God, I was so entertained.
Yes.
I was like, why are they all walking in baby steps?
Exactly.
And then I couldn't move.
I'm sure you didn't. You liked the place you were in very much so.
But I got very thirsty.
Yes, so, cotton mouth. Uh-huh, but it still can be fun.
My experience. Okay, back to you. Not about me. This is all about you. So you played high school.
I did, yes.
And do you play in a league there?
Where? In New Orleans?
In New Orleans?
Yeah, I play
in a
couple.
Do you guys have a league?
So we have an AGA league in New Orleans, the New Orleans Softball League. So that's starting up probably in February after Mardi Gras. Because it's hard to start before Mardi Gras.
I can imagine.
I play a lot of co-ed, and we started playing cabbage ball, actually, which is a New Orleans thing. It's like a ball this size, like a rubber-type-ish ball, and...
Is it bigger than a softball?
It is bigger, so it's, yeah.
Do you play with gloves or no gloves?
No, you're not... No gloves. And the field is smaller.
They have that up in Chicago, too.
Really?
Something like that. I remember as a little kid.
Yeah.
My great cousin's husband played, and this was back in the 70s. Ball was about this big, but
okay.
They didn't play with any gloves.
No, the ball is almost like those. I knew it as handball when I was younger.
Hard rubber.
Yeah, exactly. A little bit squishy, but not really squishy.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I started playing that. I don't love it.
Is this your first time here
to this
Hurricane?
No, I was here a couple years ago. I played with the Jokers a couple years ago.
I remember the Jokers.
Yeah.
They were funny as shit. Wait a minute, that was a joke. Silver Daddy has it. Okay. No.
Yes, I've been to a few tournaments.
I do. I think were they from Tampa?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I remember the Jokers.
Yeah.
I remember them well. I remember a guy on that team very well. So
that went
yeah.
Somewhere.
I wish he was here right now. No. Back to this.
That's on
what
him?
What position? I'm kidding. I'm kidding, family. Kind of. So, let's talk more about this. What I find more inspiring is the women that play in these tournaments.
Me too.
Even though it's a lot of men, the women hold their own.
I mean, it's our sport.
I know. They're like, they're kick ass, especially the ones that are in playing. I mean, there are some kick ass shortstop, left or.
I mean, listen, you just
third base, first baseman.
We know what we're doing, so you put them in a position of control or like having to know what they're supposed to do with the ball, where it goes. That's where you should put us. Because we're also less distracted by the scenery.
I'm speechless. God, she got my mind in the gutter so bad. I don't know what to say after that.
I mean, I'll tell you, in New Orleans, we have an all-women's team, which is the real fun, real fun. We enjoy each other so much. And it's really nice to travel.
Well, I guess so. If you're all women and you all like the same thing. I would hope you have a great after-hour party.
I mean.
No, but the women are very competitive. The one thing I will say, and they can hit the ball like no one else. When I say they can hit the ball, they can place the ball. Not just like, oh, if you say, hey, hit it short right center, they will pop a line drive into right center.
Mm-hmm.
They can hit the place the ball anywhere, which always advances the runners.
Yeah.
And they're fast, and they get on base.
I mean, many are. Well, not all.
But
you can't call all of us. Here's what I'll say. Like I said, I've been playing since I was 5 years old. This is our sport, right? So you tell us what you know.
You know what I'm doing,
that's what I'm going to do.
I want to see women coaching these teams is what I want to see.
We do. Look at, there's Erin, who is with the Tampa Bay Araya. She's coaching a D team.
I'm going to go find Erin.
Yes, Erin. Yeah, she's wonderful.
I got to find Erin. I got to talk to her about coaching.
A couple of women on play. So I coach my team, but the women on our team, they coach their team in Columbus. I think, you know, sometimes when we travel, we want to kind of just play, but a lot of times. But Erin here for Tampa Riot, she's coaching.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm going to try to find Erin.
Mm-hmm.
So have you played any games yet?
No, we just got moved fields.
So we
don't know what we're doing.
As a sit and wait.
Yeah.
That's the one thing about this tournament. It's a lot of, there is some sit time.
There is.
So there's times to socialize and get to meet people. So I want to thank you so much for this. I'm very, very excited to have you on the show. Hey everyone,
I'll come to New Orleans.
I will come to New Orleans.
Yeah.
I'll give you my information.
Please do.
Hey everyone, I got to go to break. When I come back, I have no clue what I'm doing today, but I'll be back. How's that? You're listening to Trippin' with Silver Daddy and
Corinne.
Thank you. Bye.
Did you know if you live within 20 miles of the ocean, there is saltpeter in the air? Saltpeter is very bad for your car. It can cause rust and dull your paint. So you need to get your car washed at least once a week if you live within 20 miles of the ocean. That's why I go to Majestic Car Wash. My Blue Beauty, I only trust Majestic Car Wash. They're located at 2781 North Federal Highway. You know, you have your choice. Your car can go through the 40-foot long cleaning tunnel, or it can be hand washed. They also have a detail shop that can make your car look brand spanking new. So where do I take my Blue Beauty? To Majestic Car Wash. You need to go there today.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Trippin' with Silver Daddy. I'm here with Tom. And Tom came all the way from up north. Like really far up north. He's here for this softball tournament. He came to see what hurricanes are about. Well, you're actually from Toronto, correct?
That's right.
So you came kind of a distance. I doubt you drove here.
No, we flew.
You flew, yeah. So I bet the weather's a little different this time of year between here and Toronto.
Oh yeah, when I left it was freezing around, 30 degrees and Fahrenheit around 0 Celsius for Canadian time.
And it's about
high today should be about 80, about 26.6.
Yeah, I'm sweating my balls off.
Yeah, it is. It's already hot this early in the morning. Have you been to this tournament before?
Yeah, this is my fifth Hurricane Showdown. I love this tournament.
Oh, you, is it because of the weather or the tournament or the bars?
And the boys.
And the boys.
Yes.
Okay, so it's a mixture of
it's all
tournament, bars, weather, and boys.
Perfect.
I kind of like all that, too. Which, okay, then we're going to, now since you've been here, probably, which favorite bar?
Oh, my Hunters. Sunday night Hunters, I can't wait.
Okay, they're not a sponsor, so we'll have to edit that
okay,
out.
Alibi.
They're not a sponsor. We'll keep going. No. None of them are sponsors, so we'll keep going. So what position do you play?
I play left center field.
Oh, thank God you didn't say catcher. But that's all I can say. Left center field, because you're a runner.
I can run.
You can run, you can throw, you can catch the ball, you can do everything.
I'm good at hunting down balls.
You're good at hunting down balls. Daddy's good at finding big bats. Okay. Besides all that then. So is there a big league up in Toronto?
It's not as big as down here. It's one of the reasons we love coming here is because of how huge it is. When we hold tournaments, we don't get this number of teams. We like the big ones, so that's why we come down to South Florida.
We heard about the Canadian boys, the big ones, yeah. Okay, on a serious note, I didn't even know softball existed up north.
Yeah.
I thought it was just ice hockey and curling.
It is. I curl too.
You curl?
In the winter I curl. Summer I play softball. But Toronto is actually one of the founding members of NAGA, which is the North American Gay Softball Association.
Very familiar
with it. In 1976, Toronto formed its league, and we've been going ever since.
Wow. That's something I didn't know. Have you ever played in the World Series?
I have never done a World Series, of all the things. I prefer coming to these tournaments. World Series is, I don't know, it's a long week. I like a weekend.
It is a long week. I did one World Series, and it was an eventful, let me just tell you. It was not what I was expecting. Because my team was more worried about losing as fast as possible so they could party the rest of the week. Because we were in Oregon, where it was legal at the time to buy gummies and other things.
Oh, yes. Yeah, your prohibition down here sucks.
Yes, it does. Let me tell you. Besides softball, you're also a college professor.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah, I study gay history, and I teach gay history.
You teach gay history?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I didn't know there was actually a course. There was never a course like that when I was there.
Neither for me, but now there is. We're starting to create it. The world is changing. Isn't it great?
Give me one fact about gay history that I should know.
Well, I just told you Toronto was one of the founding members of gay softball. I don't know. About what? You got to narrow it down.
Narrow it down. How about... something about maybe gay marriage.
Oh, okay. Well, you know, Canada was among the first countries in the world to legalize gay marriage. We legalized it in 2005, which is much sooner than you all did down here, which is fine. You caught up. It's all good.
Did you hear that? He said you all. You would think he's from Kentucky. He sounds just like my neighbors back home in Kentucky or Southern Ohio. I thought only I said you all. I love that.
It's all the Southern hospitality I've had down here.
You don't live down here, let me tell you. It's a big difference once you live here. We're just nice because you're spending money, let me tell you. Once we take all your money, guess what? You can go back home and make more.
And then come back
and then come back next summer. No, on a serious note. So you teach at the university,
yeah.
Gay history,
yeah.
Which that is kind of news, and I think that's pretty exciting.
Yeah.
Besides that, you told me you like food and wine.
Oh, yeah, it's my passion.
How's the Canadian wine? Do they make, is there many wineries?
Yeah, it's improving. It used to be a little bit immature. Now, the Niagara wine region, really nice, putting out some really nice wines. And even in British Columbia, just north of Oregon, you know, Oregon
that's
has
what
the wine
heard.
Region.
I heard region. Over in the Vancouver area.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like below the foothills, below the mountains and all that, and the valleys where it kind of has that nice warm summer. And
yeah, and that like decent amount of moisture, rain. So
moisture, rain, humidity, but not too much humidity that the mold doesn't grow, all that kind of stuff.
The right soils, so yeah. Canada's improving its wine reputation.
That's good. Yeah. And they're improving on a lot of things. I mean, most of us in America would love to move to Canada, especially if you live here in Florida. It's a little bit more liberal. And I have a lot of friends up in Toronto.
Oh, really?
I've been to Toronto many times.
Oh, cool. What's your favorite bar?
Oh, it's been so long ago. Those bars are closed.
Oh, okay.
My ex is from Rochester, and they're Asian, so we would go to Toronto to go to the Asian district and buy duck and all this other stuff and Vietnamese sandwiches and take them all back to America. So we did a lot of that. But yeah, I've been up there. I've been skiing up there in an area called Orangeville.
Yeah.
Been out there, did some snow skiing and that. Beautiful country.
Oh, it's gorgeous. Yeah, it's just cold.
It's cold this time of year.
The summer is beautiful. If you come to Toronto, come in the summer. That's the time to do it. Check out the island, which is a gay beach. It's nude. It's wonderful.
Oh my God, beautiful. It's nude too?
It's a nude beach, yes.
You know, we have one not too far from here.
Oh, really? Yeah. Oh, I didn't know that. Oh, I didn't know there was a new beach down here.
All over. It's about 20 minutes south of here.
Oh, God, it's okay.
It's like a whole section of the park is nude, but there's like a section where all the gay people go.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
So there's a family section and all of that for the people from Europe. But yeah, it's a lot going on. So how's your team doing?
We're okay. You know, we haven't played ball since September, so we're a little bit rusty. Muscles are a bit sore. So anyone who wants to work on that for us, hit us up, please.
Look what Timmy plays on. Cocktail. See? He plays on cocktail, everyone. They like to drink and party. That's for sure. So how long are you here for?
We're here. I got here Tuesday. I leave on Tuesday.
Oh, you're spending a whole week.
A whole week.
Didn't you just say you didn't want to go to the World Series because it's a week long?
It's a week long of softball.
Oh.
But I didn't want to spend that much time playing softball. So I want to come down, relax, check out Wilton, enjoy the sights and scenes.
Well, I can tell you one thing. Everyone from here and all the local teams, we're really glad to host you guys and have you guys. You are one of the two international teams that came all the way from Toronto just to play in the tournament. I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
Enjoy your time. Don't get too sunburned.
Oh, I won't. I got lavender.
You have to down here. Hey, everyone. I have to go to break. I'll be right back. You're listening to Trippin' with Silver Daddy. Be right back.
Catfish Dewey's is my favorite place to eat because they have all you can eat. Hey, they have more than that. They have a regular menu, but I like my food. And on Monday, Tuesday nights, they have all you can eat shrimp. On Wednesday, it's the barbecue baby back ribs. On Thursday and Sunday, it's that Alaska snow crab legs. On Friday, it's the fried scallops. And on Saturday, it's the fried oysters and crawfish. Hey, Catfish Dewey's has been around for 40 years because they know how to do it right. Big family environment and has a great little bar inside the place. Let me just tell you, you need to go to Catfish Dewey's. You know, they're conveniently located at 4003. North Andrews Avenue in Oakland Park, which is just north of downtown Fort Lauderdale. See you at Catfish Dewey's.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Trippin' with Silver Daddy. I have been here at Hurricane Showdown all weekend.
Me too.
And so has she. And this is Simone with the C.
Here I am.
And she is originally from Philly.
Originally.
And now she lives here in South Florida.
Definitely.
And you've been playing all weekend.
I have.
How's the team doing?
We actually did pretty good. We've been improving each game. We played about 6 games so far. And we've improved about every game. Every game we've improved.
And make sure you speak loud enough or they won't hear you.
I got you.
Because see, I'm a loud.
I got you.
You got
there
me?
There you go. I got you.
Good. So is this the first time you played in this tournament?
This is my first year in the tournament, yes.
Okay, but you play in the league down here?
I do play in the league down here. I do.
So do you know a lot of the league people?
I do know. A lot of league people are new to me.
Uh-huh.
I wouldn't say fans, but I'm getting a lot of people to know me now. A lot of people are starting to know my name.
Let me tell you, I just walked in here
And within minutes, I got to know her and her name.
That's how it goes.
Because she's like, she is like A-plus personality. I thought I was A-plus personality.
That makes us A++.
She's an A triple plus.
There we go.
Maybe five even pluses.
I'll take that.
She'll take that.
I'll take it.
What position do you play?
I play second base.
Oh, wow. So you're talented. Number two.
Number two for second base.
Yeah, no one wants to be number one because they don't do anything.
That's boring.
At first base.
Number two is always the best. You don't deal with no problem.
Yeah, number two is the one who's always involved in that double play.
Literally.
So they play all sides, let me tell you.
We do.
So, you were born and raised in Philly.
I was.
How long have you lived down here?
I've been in and out of here for about 9 years.
9 years?
About 9 years. I go back up north for a little bit, then I come back down south.
Well, you go north during the summertime? Are you the opposite of a snowbird?
No, I love snow, so I go when it's cold. Like, normally around this time, I'll be up there.
I do the same thing.
Yeah.
Because I'm from Ohio. And
what's your?
Cincinnati.
Okay.
So I like going home, like Christmas and that.
Yeah.
But after about a week,
it's ready to come back.
I'm ready to come back.
Mm-hmm. It's I feel you.
It's kind of like, okay, I did that.
It's doing too much. It's cold out here.
It's cold. Yeah, it's cold out here. And the family wants to run you around everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Out in the cold.
I'm here on vacation.
Yeah, I'm here to work. Sit and relax, sit by the fire.
I feel you.
I'll be running out in that 0 degrees
weather.
Go get
some ice. Don't your freezer make ice?
Like, I was home last year at Christmas and it was 60 below zero with wind chill.
No.
I was like, this is the craziest thing I ever did.
89 degrees in Florida. Let's go back to Florida.
Let me tell you, the weather is beautiful. And this tournament is always right after Thanksgiving. And I can tell you one thing. All the people here, let me show. There's a lot of people here. A lot of people sitting around. There's five fields at just this facility. And they're also playing at another facility. But all the guys playing, and women,
yes,
tell me they love this event.
We do.
It's one of their favorite events.
I do.
Come on up here.
At least I do.
You do.
I do.
Well, see, for us, we don't have drive far.
I don't either.
I know.
A lot of people don't. A team yesterday came from, I believe, Orlando. A couple teams yesterday came from Orlando.
I interviewed a guy from Toronto.
Yeah. Canada?
Canada. There's international teams here. And he spilled the beans.
But they're a B team, no? It wasn't a B team?
It's a D team,
right?
It was
a D team?
D.
We had a lot of B teams here yesterday, too.
What level are you?
I'm D.
D?
Right now we're D team.
D as in David. D as in delightful.
D as in dope.
Dope. Okay.
There you go.
This is the dope section.
It is.
Hey, everyone. I had a great time here at the event. This is something you need to go. As I said when I opened, it's very important as you age to be involved in things like sports. I talked a lot about the health reasons why I should probably be playing, but the other big thing, it's the social part of it.
Definitely social.
As I said, if you're involved in team sports, you stick with it longer because you're a part of that team.
Right. You're part of something.
Listen. See? They are doing team cheers. You have to be a part of team and have fun. It just helps your whole well-being when you're around people that you like.
It helps you glow.
Glow and grow.
It helps you glow.
Glow?
Glow.
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 Glow. It helps you glow.
You look amazing.
And I'm glowing because I'm already sweating.
You're glowing because you're here.
Yeah. And remember, you can always
follow
me.
Silver Daddy.
Yes, please.
I'm trying to tell you, follow Silver Daddy.
You
subscribe,
heard?
Follow, subscribe, follow, like, comment, everything you need.
I just need to bring her to everything,
everything
I do.
Need.
Hey, everyone, I hope you had a great time today. And remember, as always, love, peace, and respect.
Always.
You've been listening to Trippin' with Silver Daddy. Bye.
Have a great one.